Hello everyone, my name is Yash. I'm a product designer and a typography buff, and this is my first tutorial. I wanted to share my love for typography with you guys. Let's transform this ampersand symbol from this to this. Ready? Let's go. First step, let's do some exploration. I always begin by loosely drawing a few ampersands with the pencil tool and see which ones I like. I can draw this, or we can have a much more common one. Notice my pencil is at very high smoothing, which helps me finishing my shapes without any effort. Or I can draw something like this, which is a bit more interesting. Okay, this is not even an ampersand, but yeah, it's just about exploring right now. And I'm pretty pleased with the third one, so let's just go ahead with that. And I'll try to refine it a bit. I'll create another layer and hide the previous one. And then I'm just going to draw it again with very simple strokes and see where it goes. I think the overall shape is nice, so I'll create another iteration of this. Let's lower the opacity to 20. I'll create a new layer and I'll trace it on top. And I'll try to fix what I don't particularly like about this first draft, which is mainly these upper parts, and I want to be a little more condensed. I really try to give it a freehand feel by doing more fluid hand movements. Okay, let's repeat the process one more time. This time I'll start with this tail right here. Let me increase the smoothing to 100. Maybe that was a little too much. It's okay if you don't get the shape you want a first few times. Just keep on trying. I'll go for another iteration and I think I'll try out a thinner stroke here. Alright, this is pretty good. Now it's just about finishing these lines with the node tool. I'm just going to shape it according to my liking. The way I do this is by moving the nodes to different positions and editing the angle of the handles until the curve looks good to me. Let's hide the previous draft. Okay, so I like this much better than the other ones. Remember, this is still a sketch, so it's not meant to be perfect just yet. You can also select multiple nodes at once, by the way. Now let's just try to bring them closer. And here let's try to make it smoother. I've decided to drag this much further in, move toward the center of the glyph, and bring this other curve to match. Alright, I think I like this as the overall shape, but it's time to give it more volume around the curves. And there's a super easy way to do it. All we need to do is turn the stroke mode from regular to brush. I have this brush selected for now, but from the brush editing panel, I can customize it even further. I want this to be a little more thicker, this part also, and this area here as well. So I'm going to start editing this line in the contour window and check which changes delivers what result. This is the horizontal cross section of my brush and I can control it super easily by adding, moving or removing nodes. I think this is it. I can save this as a new brush. And then I will increase the width. Now we can truly see the effect of the brush shape. I'm not sure about these overlapping bits, so I'll pull these nodes here. This is a bit too thick now, so let me go back and change it. And while I'm here, I can make a couple more edits as well. Then for this stroke here, it's very easy. I can actually save this and then just switch the mode to brush with one tap. And I can keep this or pick some other brushes that I experimented with. This one can work as a base. And again, we are just going to edit it like we did the other brush. Alright, at this point, I think it would be a good idea to delete some of the nodes. The fastest way to do is by tapping the button here, which deletes the node automatically in a way that my original shape is still preserved to a larger extent. And then I'm going to go manually to delete some nodes here as well. This allows me to be much more precise and to manipulate the shape exactly how I want. As I delete the nodes, I'm refining the resulting curves until they are as smooth as I want them to be. A general rule of thumb is, the fewer the nodes, the smoother the curve. So here you can see me making micro changes to the shapes. I think that's the blessing and curse with letter design. Every anchor point is precious. It's honestly very hard to stop. I sometimes need someone to tell me to stop, or I need a strict deadline. Okay, so now I'm really happy with the shape, but we can edit it even more. To gain even more control over the curves, we can turn the stroke into an outline. Did you catch the change? The nodes moved from middle of the shape to its edges. A lot of nodes were generated, but I can simplify it again using the deletes node function. Let's do the same for our second shape. And now I'll keep on editing even further. Here's a fun fact about the difference between lettering and calligraphy. I'm actually doing lettering because I have much more control over the refinement of the glyphs in the character that I'm creating. Whereas in calligraphy, it's much more daring, organic, independent, and you shouldn't really fix your mistakes there. Because if you do, that just ruins the inherent value of calligraphy. Here I just keep on editing and editing and editing. But finally, I think I'm happy with it for now. Although I see a lot of minor changes that I still can make. But let's skip it to the next part. This is the design that I prepared for my ampersand, and it's probably a vinyl cover. Now let's see how I can integrate it. First, I'm going to select my layers and create a more unified shape with the Shape Builder tool. This is the merge mode, by the way. And I'll just copy and paste my unified shape onto my other artboard. I can resize it, I can also stretch it, I don't necessarily need to preserve its proportions, and don't want it to be black, so let's change the color. Okay, this looks good to me. One last detail, I want the ampersand to be in between the words love and peace. So I just move the ampersand layer behind love, and I think it brings much more depth to the composition as a whole. Let's bring it out a bit. And here I just want to overshoot it from the top and bottom as well. Okay, it's time for my usual micro adjustments. We really wanted to show you guys the entire process of creating a glyph from start to finish. So hopefully you enjoyed the fact that we didn't cut out any parts. And with that, we are done. This is the final design of the glyph, and let's call it the album cover. I really had fun creating this tutorial. Stay tuned for more. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and click on another video to keep learning. Bye-bye.